gentlemen, welcome to the Ross Patterson Revolution!
Welcome to the Ross Patterson Revolution. Happy President's Day, kids. As always, I've got the podcast extraordinaire with me, breaking the glass ceiling, the one and only Jesse Wiseman, a.k.a. J-Dubs, a.k.a. Jables.
Jables. What up, dog?
Oh, is that what I'm getting? A what up, dog?
Very presidential today.
This is your favorite holiday.
It really is. Besides Columbus Day, I go nuts.
You go real hard on President's Day.
Oh yeah,
big
I'm day drinking. Isn't that? It's one of those holidays.
It's one of those holidays.
At the beach. Yeah.
Everybody's partying that we know.
Oh God. Yeah.
Yeah. I think there's a parade. There's a parade in the middle of the Potomac where George Washington crossed the river.
Yes, and that's
I think people line up down the river, and they bring what they do is they dig up his coffin every year,
yeah,
and they send it down the boat,
sort of like a flotilla with lights,
whole thing, and it's a big, it's a huge celebration.
Big
fan. I don't want to understate how big a fan I am of President's Day.
Really,
matter of fact, I really want to amp it up a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I really, really want to show my love and affection for President's Day.
Okay.
It's one of those times where it's, if you think back of the greats, obviously Washington, who is named and aforementioned as a forefather, if you will.
Sure.
Then we're going to Lincoln. All the way Trump.
So just those three.
Well, I mean, that's pretty much it, right? Do we have anybody? I don't
think there was any other
president. Who's on that monument? Who's carved into the mountain? Is it FDR?
No,
it's not. Yeah. It's not. I think they're leaving part of that mountain open for Donald John Trump.
Yeah, you couldn't even say that.
I think they're leaving part of that mountain open.
You couldn't.
I think he might just carve himself in that.
He's gonna pay for that.
Yeah. Also, to the audience, want to apologize. We had a screening of FDR American Badass, a classic presidential fave. I'm the filmmaker behind that movie. Also star in it. We held a live screening on Facebook last night. And the power went out in Wilmington, North Carolina. Gone. With about 20 minutes left. Complete nightmare shutdown. Reminded me of Silicon Valley. For those of you who watch Silicon Valley, we're not there yet. We're just not there yet technologically. I don't know why. Like, we're seeing all this cool shit on TV where they're like, oh, you're there. You can stream everywhere you want. You can put a camera on your fucking asshole and you can shit out to the world. You can't. You're still limited by little things like, it's a little tiny power outage, or, you know, why wasn't that video fed into the system? I don't know. I don't have all the answers.
Right.
Not one of those people.
Yeah.
But that's what happened, and we apologize for it. We'll do some screenings again, though. We will.
Yeah, and we hope that you give us another chance.
Another shot at it. We've had some screenings before, and they went great.
It was just this freak power outage where it was like gorgeous night. There was no reason why that should happen except for if someone was like, you know what, I want to fuck with you a little
bit. Happy President's Day. Happy President's Day, motherfucker.
This just a flash
this
like that.
is for President Taft. Like a big Taft fan.
Sure.
I think Taft or Garfield, one of those was from Ohio. I think it's like, hey.
Right.
Yeah, you said some disparaging remarks about LeBron James once.
I know one of them was the fattest.
Yeah, one of them was the fattest. It was Taft. Taft was the fattest.
Yeah.
Fun fact. Welcome to the show, kids. As you know, we got a few sponsors who actually pay for this to be on the air.
Still surprised.
Still shocked every time.
Still shocked.
First and foremost, and I'm going to need this today. I'm talking about StrikeForceEnergy.com. It's the tastiest, tiniest little tin pouch. It goes in every type of liquid you could possibly imagine. I'm gonna go ahead and fill my water up with it today. I'm gonna give it a few squirts. Bing, bing.
Oh, whoa! Wow.
Some people say I don't really need Strikeforce. Don't know why. Don't know why.
But is it that they've only known you on Strikeforce?
Maybe.
Do you know what I mean?
Maybe.
Because it's all.
Maybe Strikeforce
has
become that big a part of my life that people are like, "Oh shit, we only know Ross on Strikeforce."
But it's now like kind of your personality.
Kind of.
Strikeforce has made you who you are.
Strikeforce has made me who I am. Go to StrikeForceEnergy.com. Type in the promo code REVOLUTION. You get 20% off. Kick the can, kids. You don't need the can anymore. You saw me just squirt this little tiny tin pouch into a fucking bottle of water.
Boom.
You're good to go for the day.
See ya.
They also have a subscription of the month club. You can just get this shit dropped off at your house, which is nice. Once a month. And they ship everywhere in the entire world, which is nice. That's a nice thing they're doing at Strikeforce Energy. And they got that bottle over there on the bar with that squirts out that you see. That's a fine, fine thing. Next up, we're talking about satisfying your inner carnivore. I'm talking about carnivoreclub.co. That's a CO. That's a .co. Carnivoreclub.co is it's a meat of the month club. One of the tastiest things that comes to mind. I'm not even going to say a guilty pleasure. Because I don't feel guilty when I eat that
you
much
shouldn't.
Meat.
It's a luxury.
Yeah, but it's spicy spreadable with pork. They got salami. They got bacon, chorizo. I'm every month I kill that box within a week, and then I'm just like,
I shame eat.
Them too. So if you need a gift for a loved one or a bro, you don't know what to get them a fucking box of meats. They've also got a meat of the month club. And if you type in the promo code REVOLUTION, you get 20% off as well. They're on Fuegs. They are on
killing
Fuego.
It. Killing the meat
next
game.
Up, we got StraightRazors.com. Pano, let's get a shot of the StraightRazors.com. Big, big fan of those. Every morning I use it. Edge up the neck with it. Not afraid. Also wearing the cologne in the aftershave. Aftershave's number one in the world. Cologne, number one in the world. They've got the dopest shaving products on the planet.
I love their cologne.
Yes, yes.
I sharpened a straight razor on a belt.
With a belt, and because it comes with a belt.
It's very, it's old school, it's awesome, but like really well made. And
yeah.
I do love it.
It's great. Last but not least, we got, look, if you go to straightrazors.com and type in the promo code REVOLUTION, you're getting 10% off. So, look, it's almost like stealing it. When you see how well made their products are, you're like, oh shit, maybe
are
I
they
should.
Making money? Yeah.
Are they making money off this? Because it's kind of incredible. Last but not least, we got At Night She Cries While He Rides His Steed, their first ever romance novel for dudes. Can I get a horse noise, Jables? Best in the biz. Woman of a thousand voices.
Yeah.
Woman of a thousand voices.
I'm so good.
When's your show open in Vegas? You got a one woman thing where you're doing in Vegas, right?
Me and Jeff Dunham.
Yep.
We're going back to back.
Back to back seas. Yeah.
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 So it's gonna be him with the puppets, and then I'm gonna come out and do a couple just really great
sound effects.
Yeah.
The Michael Winslow of our generation is what a lot of people are calling you online. You can pick up At Night She Cries While He Rides His Steed. Amazon, BarnesandNoble.com, every .com you can possibly imagine, Walmart.com. And it's written by me, the greatest author who ever lived. So you're welcome. You're welcome from my brilliance. Back to that one man show, Jables. A lot of people are buying tickets.
We're selling out.
Yeah.
Because I think Celine Dion left the building.
Mm-hmm.
And Mariah's gone. So I'm kind of being couched as like the new.
Yep.
Them.
The new
the
them.
New diva.
A lot of people are saying, and this is again people off the streets. I'm getting a lot of phone calls to pay phones.
Right.
And to my landlines.
Well, they paid you first and then you
they
paid
me and then I fax them back and then I usually go to a gas station, use a payphone. But they're all saying I can't get tickets to this one woman show of the Jablers. Yeah,
they're
in Vegas.
They're not finding it?
No, they're not finding it at all.
Oh, it's Woman of a Thousand Voices / Jeff Dunham. I don't know.
I would love if Jeff Dunham just got flooded with requests of like,
for me, do it, guys.
To do a shitty, you get on stage, you do one shitty horse noise, the crowd erupts, and then you walk off stage and you're done.
It's all just like you're drinking done. Bros and yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Since it is President's Day, Jables, who was your favorite president? Again, Donald John Trump withstanding. You got to pick because we don't know.
Him.
He's only been in for a couple weeks. So right, you can't choose him.
I can't choose him. Even if I wanted to, I can't. Clinton.
Bill Clinton.
Is that?
Well, no, I guess you know in your lifetime,
off,
that's
like what I go off of is like what your parents said, like how they felt about it, because at that time they were the ones like more affected
by a president,
right?
Correct.
So
yeah.
It was like they missed Clinton.
Sure. Sure. No, I get that.
For me, that's, and he was pimpy.
He was pimpy. He was pimpy as fuck. Is it weird that I still go back to DDL, Daniel Day-Lewis playing Lincoln? And that's kind of, that's like how I hoped Lincoln was. So like,
so Lincoln, my,
yeah, Abraham Lincoln's my favorite. A little known fact about me, the longest paper, which actually kind of got me into writing, probably made me the man I am today. Ooh. I had to write a high school paper about Abraham Lincoln, like a book report. So I had to read this biography on Abraham Lincoln. And I think that set me down the road of like, because you know me, I like documentaries. I only like to read biographies. I don't like to read.
And you like historical.
Historical like, piece. Yeah. So I would say a hard Lincoln. I would say a hard Lincoln is my.
Calling him hard?
Well.
Hard Lincoln?
Is that not the correct terminology I'm using? Is that
you'll take a hard Lincoln?
I'll take a hard Lincoln anything.
Sounds like some kind of
I'll take a hard Lincoln. Yeah.
Some kind of sexual position.
It sounds like an ass play position. Like
for sure, if you're gonna take a hard Lincoln.
Why don't you give me the hard Lincoln? Why don't you give me the hard Lincoln?
Don't meme that, guys.
Don't meme hard Lincoln.
Slash.
I got a hard Lincoln today. I got a hard Lincoln. And also, like, I like the femme voice that Daniel Day-Lewis did with Lincoln too, to match that whole thing.
But apparently that's how it was.
I know
it wasn't like he just made a choice.
Here's the thing: there was only like a couple documented circumstances and books that said he talked like that. If that wasn't, because there was no cameras or audio back then, didn't do that. If somebody didn't write that down in a book, you could have made Lincoln like a hard ass, like,
like a hard
emancipation,
Lincoln.
Motherfucker.
Take my hard Lincoln.
Yeah. But instead, somebody wrote in a biography somewhere that knew him was just like, oh, he had this very kind of high-pitched voice.
But it was everywhere. Everyone said that's how he talked.
Well, there was like two people. Let's face it. It was the 1850s, late 1850s.
So there was only two people
in
the world.
Two people a lot. Like, who the fuck were they?
Sure.
And who outed them of like, oh, he had this really femme, high-pitched voice. Like, you could have said, no, Lincoln was a goddamn man. It was probably somebody who didn't like Lincoln.
Listen, we don't fact check here.
We don't fact check anything.
You know?
I could have been fake news. Could have been fake news. You know,
all
you never
the
know.
Way back then.
All the way back then. Somebody who just had a vendetta against Lincoln was like, oh yeah, that motherfucker did all that awesome shit. He talked like a woman.
Dude, that'd be the best fucking.
Kind of like the ultimate like troll of all time where you're like, oh man, did they fuck over Lincoln like that? But luckily DDL came out, Daniel Day-Lewis, rocked the shit out of it.
Made it cool kind of.
Yeah. So he made it cool.
Yeah.
So, look, if it weren't for Spielberg and DDL, I think that could have gone a different route. A different route. Yeah. I think you could have had, like, Ben Affleck playing Lincoln and then him doing some femme voice.
Oh, God.
Imagine that. Yeah. Sleep on that for a little bit. Drink that in, if you will. Who's your since it is President's Day, your celebrity president bang pass. Like, who is it?
Oh, John F. Kennedy.
Mm.
That's a fucking easy one, right? Ladies.
Yeah, yeah.
Ladies.
Yeah.
You know what I'm more partial to is Secretary of Education, though?
Yeah, yeah. Who's
Arnie
your favorite?
Yeah. Duncan. 2009 was so hot.
Yeah, yeah, that guy.
You know.
You start to have a celebrity Secretary of Education bang pass.
Bang pass.
Yeah, you're like, wait, what?
I could say it's anyone. You're like, oh, okay. I was like, he was Secretary of Education.
Couldn't tell you. Was he under Obama?
Yes.
Was he the guy that played basketball with him all the time?
I think so.
Yeah, he was in all of the celebrity All-Star games. Yeah. I actually do know that guy. But if you said his name without saying...
For sure, and not like a picture, yeah.
Yeah, or saying he was the basketball guy. He was always playing basketball. Wouldn't know who he was.
Yeah.
Wouldn't know who he was.
Yeah.
I get that. I would say...
what's your... Okay,
my first lady. My first lady. Bang pass.
Yeah.
That's... Well, it would have been Jackie O. Would have been Jackie Kennedy.
Okay, but then would that would be weird. That would be like a swingers party.
So right. But oddly enough, if you're looking back at presidential history, that was the best first looking couple all the way around. And I'm sure every man and woman would have said both of them across. It's not like you're like, oh, Mary Todd. God, I had to get me some Mary Todd.
Barbara Bush.
Yeah. Eleanor Roosevelt. No one had a face, an elegance, a beauty like Eleanor Roosevelt. No, I think you would have said them right off the bat. Yeah. But Melania comes around and boom, boom. Let me say it's definitely Melania now, like with a bullet. You got to see her in person.
It's striking.
Hot as a baker, not in my nature, not because I hate you. It's crazy, right?
It's striking.
Great.
You're like, whoa. I did not expect to feel that way about you.
And it's weird because she looks beautiful on camera.
Mm-hmm.
So you're like, she can't be that hot in real life. And you see her in real life, you're like, God damn it.
Yeah.
And she's like 47.
It translates, yeah.
I didn't, it's crazy. She's 47. Whatever she's doing or drinking, that's
money.
The,
it's a lot of money.
Yeah, oh, is that you think so?
Yeah, she's got a lot of money, so you can look good at any age, and that's a well-known fact. So,
well, look, some say money, some say God-given. Could be God-given.
It's money.
Yeah, good.
But partly, there has to be some genes, like Jennifer Lopez, like. She has to have a good base to start with.
Sure.
So that the money goes to, is a good
investment. Yeah, Jennifer Lopez is another one who's like, what is she, 47, 48?
Yes.
And just still killing the game where you're just like.
But like, gee.
Yeah. It's crazy.
It's crazy.
The two of them are beating time. And Jennifer Aniston, we can't forget about Jennifer Aniston still beating the clock.
I did forget about her.
Yeah. Weird.
I constantly forget about
her. Yeah. She's in the mix with that. Yeah. She's definitely in the mix with that.
Yeah.
But here's the thing I love about President's Day too. Usually the All-Star Weekend. NBA All-Star Weekend's around this time.
Oh, that's right.
It's a nice thing. It's a fun thing for me. I enjoy the celebrity All-Star game for the NBA. Usually on Friday nights it starts off with a celebrity game. The kid from Stranger Things. I don't know his name on the show. The little black kid. He was in
That's great.
The New Edition movie on BET, which I loved.
Yeah.
Big fan. He was there. He rocked it. I want to play. We're going to have some friends. When we get to March Madness, I want to have some friends on the show and discuss this debate. I always said I could light up a celebrity game.
I think so.
And then when you get out there, it's a different story.
Right. You think one thing.
Yeah. Yeah. So you think you're like, shit. Still got it. Still got it like I do in high school. Still good.
Yeah.
I remember in my 20s, all the way through college, I was dunking a basketball in college. I'm a tall man. Tall drink. 6'3".
Sure.
I could dunk a basketball. Dunked a basketball in college. Felt great about it. Moved to Los Angeles right afterwards. We used to play pickup games all the time. Still felt like I was the best on the floor at that time. Still felt confident in my skills, but then, you know, started getting movies and stuff, and you want to mess up the rig. The problem is once you get out of college, start playing basketball like that, get a lot of injuries. People are throwing wild elbows, you know, you're getting broken nose, black eyes, blowing out knees, and you're just like, is that worth it? Is it really worth it? Like what I do for risking what I do for a living just to play basketball for a couple. So I stopped playing.
Okay.
And this is going to come back around. So a buddy of mine calls, just finished doing a movie with him. And he goes, hey man, there's a celebrity league in Los Angeles. Like DiCaprio and Tobey Maguire, all those guys used to play. And they were like, can you come down and play? we need a fill-in, you know, for a game. And you can do like a stretch. Like this one guy's going to be out for five games.
DiCaprio?
Yeah, DiCaprio plays in it.
Leonardo?
Yeah, yeah. So he used to. Yeah, I know. It's crazy, right? And like everybody was like, oh, Leo's great about, he's not great at basketball.
He's great at everything else.
He's great at everything else. Basketball is a different story.
I'll give him the pass.
Because like, I think the game before us was, so it was DiCaprio, Tobey Maguire was playing. And then they were playing against, you remember Brian McKnight's? This is how we do it.
Yes,
that guy was playing against him. He, for real, was a fucking legit awesome basketball player. Torched him. And you were just like, oh, well, this is fucking ridiculous. Like, because I'd heard these stories that like DiCaprio and them were really great at basketball. No. And then somebody like, you know, Brian McKnight or maybe, is it Jordan McKnight?
I think it's Jordan Knight.
No, that's New Kids. I'm gonna stand firm on Brian McKnight. I'm gonna stand firm on that. You fact check that for me real time.
I'm gonna fact check one thing.
Anywho's, McKnight drops 30. He drops 30 in this game, and it was just like, oh shit, that's a real player.
Yeah, that's Brian McKnight.
Yeah,
sorry.
It is Brian. This is how we do it. Whenever you fact check me now from any time going forward, I'm just gonna sing out. This is how we do it.
This is how we do it.
Yeah, South Central does it like nobody does. So he drops 30 in this game, and then we're up. They clear the floor. We're up. We're next to play. And again, hadn't played at this point in maybe 8 years. I think I'm 30, 31. You know, whatever. I hadn't played in like 8 years at this point.
Okay.
So I get in there. Have a few warm up shots. You know, beforehand, lighting it up. I feel great.
Sure.
Feel great. Mm-hmm. Then the referees come out, and I'm like, oh shit. Shit, this is
like, I'm ready.
This is real now. Mm-hmm. There's a jump ball. You're playing full court. It's not like a half court bullshit of 3-on-3. It's 5-on-5.
Okay.
We didn't have any substitutes because I was filling in. That's the thing about celebrities. They're not reliable and they're not on time. Weird, right? They can't even be bothered to show up on time for a game.
Sure, that they like elected to do.
Problem with that is game starts. We're 5-on-5. I am exhausted. I am doubled over. Like 10 minutes in, just heaving. I'm looking over this empty bench. I got nobody to substitute with me. So I got to stay on the floor.
Oh God, did you puke?
Felt like it. I got dangerously close to puking. Oh, God. Dangerously close to puking.
Yeah.
10 minutes in, I'm gassed, but everybody's gassed. Every single person is gassed. Making baskets at that point was like we were 3-year-olds. Where it was just like
like grannying it up.
And then people started fouling each other, so you could take a break and shoot free throws from the free throw line.
Okay.
And it was just like at halftime, you know, when you haven't worked out in a long time, and you were like, man, I got to get back in the swing of things. I'm going to run 10 miles today.
Sure.
It's exactly how I felt. Like where you're in hysterical blindness. I was in like a Temple Grandin sitch where I didn't know what was going on and where I was. And I was just like, oh my God, I still had some of my senses, but some, like other motor skills didn't work. And I'm like, oh shit, the second half is about to start. I gotta do this again. Like keep going through this again.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Sounds like a nightmare.
I ended up scoring a few buckets. And at the end of the game, everybody's so gassed. This guy could have shot it. They were down by two, about 5 seconds left. This guy shot a 3-pointer to win, and I knew it. And I barely had energy left in me. I ran out, I blocked a shot, and we won the game. Right? Sounds heroic. Sounds like I'm just telling another heroic Ross Patterson story about how awesome I am.
Sure.
No, I'm not actually.
Huh.
Because the final scoreboard was 28-26. Full game, full grown men, 28-26 in this celebrity league. There, we went to a friend of ours. One of
it
our best friends
like
has got
a
10-year-old girls game the other day. It was 36-33 when we were at the game.
Yeah.
Ours with grown men playing full court basketball was 28-26 in this celebrity league. And it was just like, I'm not going to out who else was playing. So I will say this. Somebody from Entourage was playing. That's all I'm going to say. But at the end of it, like, I am... I'm gassed. They're like, I got nothing left. I can't go on anymore. You know, people are high-fiving or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And but everybody else seemed like okay about the game, where it was just like oddly comfortable about the score, where it was just like, oh. So like, you guys are used to 28 to 26 games, like for a full, and they seemed okay with it. I go home. I'm dead the rest of the day. I mean, I got nothing in me. I think I might have went to Baja Fresh, picked up a Dos Manos, a two-hander burrito, ate that on the sofa, and I was out for the rest of the day.
Like a toddler that played in the sandbox.
Yeah, all day. In the sun. But it was indoors, so I didn't even have that excuse. I wasn't even in the sun. It wasn't even like the shiny L.A. sunshine.
You're lame, dude.
I know. So phone rings 5 days later, and it's my buddy again, and he's like, hey, man. You ready for the game tonight? I was like, I got to go to an editing session. And he was like, dude, we just finished that movie like, you know, a week ago. How do you? And I was like, yeah.
I want to get on it.
Gotta start now. It. I was like, the footage hadn't even transcoded yet. It wasn't even in the editor didn't even have it. I couldn't do it.
So now you know why the celebrities didn't show up that you were talking shit about
Correct.
Earlier.
So. We circle back to Friday night, the celebrities that did play in it. And this is something I dreamed about my entire life.
Yeah.
Now I feel like I would almost embarrass myself. I feel like I would almost embarrass.
Like they have to be.
I don't
training.
Have that dream. Exactly. Yeah. And I don't have that dream anymore of no, playing in the busy. Celebrity game during the All-Star weekend. Don't have that dream.
That's great. I love when people like are able to give up dreams like that.
Yeah. Yeah.
And be okay with
it. But be honest about your skills and your life set.
I love
One of these
that.
Days, we're going to have some. I want to get some of my friends who are older on the show who still play basketball and pickup league. And I want you to hear their conversations. We'll get them on the show for March. Okay. We'll get them on the show for March Madness.
Okay.
And I want you to hear them talk about basketball and what they could do at this age. Because every guy is going to tell you, every guy is going to tell you an opposite story of what I just said. They're going to be like, I still got it.
Still
do it. No, you can't. No, you cannot. Just the physical
Promise
endurance
that
it takes to go up and down for a full court. Could you do it in a 3-on-3 half court, like 3-point, you know, in the backyard? Yeah, you could. You could not go a full court game like the celebrity All-Star game. You just can't.
Yeah.
You just can't. Another fun thing about that I look forward to every All-Star weekend, 3-point shootout and the dunk contest.
Yes, you do.
Mm-hmm. Big fan. Big fan of the 3-point shootout and the dunk contest. They also got a skills challenge that I enjoy.
Okay.
Where they have they dribble, they shoot a 3-pointer, layup, free throw, as fast as you can, and I like that. It's a nice addition.
I know what those words mean.
Yeah. Well, you know,
I know what those words mean. That's what I was asking.
Yeah, of course, but not strung out together, obviously.
Nah,
you're.
I know what dribbling.
You're Netflix and what is it? The Table Chef.
There's new episodes of Chef's Table.
Yeah. So I'm downstairs watching this. I'm excited because I think last year was great. The 3-point contest came down to Steph Curry and Klay Thompson.
I do remember that though,
and it was awesome. And I was like, oh shit, Steph Curry. Didn't enter this year. Don't know why. He's the best 3-point shooter on the planet. Doesn't enter in street clothes. It's just sitting on the bench. And I'm like, all right. But Klay Thompson entered.
Okay.
And that was also you could add Kevin Durant in there. Didn't enter. Don't know why. Why the best players aren't doing it? Couldn't tell you. Klay Thompson, then they were like, well, he won last year. He's definitely going to win this year. Didn't even make it out of the first round. Didn't even make it out of the first round.
What?
Yeah. Shocking. Where I was just like, what the fuck? So then it was down to Kyrie Irving, who was great. Eric Gordon. And I believe Eric Gordon was the one who ended up winning it. And I was just, it was kind of a snooze. And I was just, they went into overtime, which was fine. But like, there's nothing like seeing Klay Thompson and Steph Curry when they're on. Really light up a basketball
killing
game.
It. Yeah. Yeah. And something must have been going on. Why did they all not do it?
So that's what I thought too. Then there was a midpoint break. The announcer, Craig Sager, who recently passed away, won the ESPY, the Arthur Ashe
awesome.
Award of Courage, passed away. They did a tribute to him. and they had celebrities and players come out and shoot three-pointers. $10,000 a shot for cancer.
For his fund.
Yeah, awesome. Foundation. And that was great. They had Anthony Anderson come out. DJ Khaled.
Oh, you can't.
We the best.
We could get him here for $20,000.
Well, I like DJ Khaled. I like him too,
but he'll go anywhere.
Shit. He's built an empire for himself, and I like his whole shit. So
I'm down.
DJ Khaled comes out, drains a three.
Really?
All over the internet goes bug fuck. Drains a three-pointer. DJ, we the best. He can live off that shot the rest of his life. And then after that, they raised $130,000 in a minute.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. There was 13 shots made in a minute by celebrities and former players, a couple of WNBA players. Candace Parker was one. She made one. Fantastic.
Nice.
So then they say, all right, now we will bump this pot up to $500,000. We will throw in an extra $370,000 if Steph Curry can come out of the stands and hit a half-court shot. Yeah. So Steph Curry is like, bet, dude. I'm ready. Takes off his watch, hands it to somebody.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah. They give him three shots.
Okay.
You want to take a stab at what happened?
No.
He missed him.
No.
Whole world's watching. Craig Sager's wife is there. His son is there. Then they're like, great, we're going to do, hey, how about you're getting warmed up? We're going to do three more. Missed him.
How does that happen?
And then somebody else, and another announcer goes, I'll tell you what, Steph, just keep shooting. Keep shooting. He misses 10 half-court shots in a row. And then they've got to move on after that. They're like, okay, you're done. And they physically had to take the ball away from him. And they were like, you can go back and sit in the stands and do nothing.
What is that? Is that mental? Is that what is that?
Shooting a half court shot is hard. He does it frequently, so frequently that's
what I mean.
One would think it's pretty easy for him.
I know it's not easy, but
it's not easy.
I've just seen him do it a million
times.
So
many times in live games. Why couldn't you just do it more like
Trump
goes 0 for 10.
It's Trump.
You know, President's Day. We're just, not going negative on President's Day. So he misses those. They bring Craig Sager's kid out of the stand to dunk the basketball for the extra $370,000. They give $500,000. It was awesome.
Okay.
And that was a nice
moment.
So
they got it.
Yeah, they got it. Okay. And that was a nice moment.
Just no thank you, Steph Curry.
Yeah, exactly. No thank you, Steph Curry. Again, internet has a field day.
He needs to donate like a bunch of money.
Yeah, I know. I'm sure he did. I hope. But he probably got on and was just like, hey, by the way, here's for me missing those shots.
Yeah.
Like, congratulations. Yeah. I'm really sorry.
Yeah.
After that was the dunk contest, which no celebrities, like famous NBA players. I call them celebrities because that's essentially what they are. LeBron James is more than just a basketball player. He's a celebrity at this point, a global icon, if you will. Why that guy's not entering the dunk contest, can't tell you. I don't know why. But he's not in it. None of them are in it.
Did Kobe used to do it?
Kobe did it. Kobe did it once.
Did he always do it?
He did it, I would say, for 2 or 3 years. And that's about your time because you don't want to keep winning. Kobe won it and then you move on. Jordan did it, you know, 3 or 4 times. You win it and then you move on. But you do it. LeBron James has never done it.
Never done it.
Never done it. All the greats have done it in their time. He didn't. He's never done it in his career.
Interesting.
Yeah, strange. And I think it's, you know, he's afraid of... of losing.
Steph Curry.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Losing a dunk. Because everybody would be like, how did LeBron James lose a dunk contest?
Yeah.
Well, how did Klay Thompson lose a three-point contest? How does Steph Curry miss all those half-court shots? It happens.
It happens.
And I think he doesn't want to ruin his brand. I think people are too concerned about their brand nowadays. So it's a bunch of young kids who come in. They're nervous. The world's watching. And it's just a bunch of shitty missed dunks. And it wasn't good. It wasn't good this year.
Put
a damper on it. Put a damper on All-Star Weekend for me. Then the game last night.
Sorry. Okay.
Now the game made up for it. Because the top news was Kevin Durant in the offseason went to the Golden State Warriors.
Oh, I love this drama.
I know. This
gets me into it.
Yeah.
Like this kind of drama.
And you know, his B-Fry, what, Russell Westbrook, Russ.
Yeah.
He didn't call him before he left to go to the Warriors.
Yeah.
Now they're playing on the same All-Star game.
Hate each other.
And
talking shit
when they're playing during the regular season. They're getting booed. And in the middle of the second quarter, Durant tosses up a lob to Westbrook, who dunks it, and it's just this, you know, the crowd goes crazy, everybody goes crazy. They still didn't shake hands afterwards.
Oh, but it was like a little moment?
Was a moment. And then they called timeout, and the entire bench rallied around them and started cheering. They gave him a standing ovation just for the two of them. And both were laughing on the bench, but they still didn't shake hands. Still didn't shake hands.
Takes time. You know, with guys, it takes a little bit more time.
I would say that's true.
There's not going to be a sit down. It's going to be a couple situations like that. And then it's going to sort of be like, whatever, dude. Like, sorry, fuck it.
Yeah.
Like, they won't, they'll have to get over it. It won't ever be like.
Probably.
A thing.
Probably. But they're, because they're going to be playing in all-star games for years to come. They might even meet in the playoffs, which would be unbelievable. Because Russell Westbrook right now is probably my favorite player.
Would he ever be asked to go to the Warriors?
Would he be asked?
Contracts up. Are there any, is there a world where...
No, not for a long time. Okay. He signed an extension after Durant left and was like, fuck you, I'm going to stay in this city. I'm not going
to
leave.
I just like
city.
To make it more drama.
Right.
Yeah.
But they could meet in the playoffs. And I will say this. Russell Westbrook was shoving players last night. You don't typically see that in an All-Star game. He was playing hard.
Like it meant something.
Oh, yeah. It meant something to him. And I think he ended up with like 42 points.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, he kills. And he goes hard every fucking play. Big fan of that guy. Big fan. So that kind of saved All-Star Weekend for me personally.
The drama.
Yeah, the drama. Yes.
I wanted to see that. Can I compare it to the Real Housewives for just 1 second?
Absolutely.
It's just a bunch of really rich people.
Yes.
Like, you're just watching a bunch of millionaires, like, play a game.
Yeah. Yeah, we are.
And then fight a little. And then you want to know about their drama.
I know.
Same.
I know. And the way they're setting it up now. You know, it's funny you say that. The last 2 years, there's been a fashion show.
Oh, God. See.
With the NBA players.
See, yeah. Like, you guys.
Yeah.
You don't want to admit it, but that's your reality show.
Here's the other thing that I found super interesting about the NBA All-Star game was Jay-Z and Beyonce. We're courtside with Blue Ivy.
Of course.
The child who we know, like...
The chosen one.
Yeah. But during the game, all the players were going over and paying respects to them.
Excuse me?
Yep. Just...
Like offering like frankincense and myrrh and stuff?
Yeah. And just, you know, high-five and handshaking. A lot of hugs, a lot of winks, a lot of waves. I would venture to say... They're like our modern day JFK and Jackie. It's not the Obamas.
Obamas are the Obamas. Like, they'll still do that too. Like, they'll
But I'm telling you, I'm just talking about the grand spectrum of fame and who you want to meet and hang out with in real life.
Okay.
I think people would be genuinely more excited in day to day life to meet Beyonce and Jay-Z rather than the Obamas.
Oh, for sure.
And that's crazy.
Yes, and that's crazy.
That's crazy. They're
even their hand in the whole Cuba situation, like, that put them right up. I mean,
yeah. They were there. They were the first ones in Cuba.
Yeah.
Jay-Z and Beyonce somehow were the first ones in Cuba.
And it was
we were
oddly political. Like, it was very
Yeah. Cuz you know they had to get clearance from somebody. Mm-hmm. You know the clearance came from the Obamas. Sure. Which, you know, they're beef fries, so why not? Yeah. Why not go and hang in Cuba? The mustache is tickling my nose today. Oh. I do not have this thing tamed. I should have used some straightrazors.com.
The beard oil.
The beard oil. Yeah. I should have. And I did not. It is tickling me today. I got a few scratches on my nose with the stash. But yeah, I would say Jay-Z and Beyonce is the modern day Camelot right now.
They're working. Yeah. They're quickly becoming.
She's having twins, and after the Grammy performance with introducing the babies to the world, that's kind of the royalty.
Allegedly.
You still think she's faking a pregnancy?
There's a lot of things that she can do.
But I mean, again, to come and sit courtside at the NBA All-Star game,
and have every single person like think of you as
it was almost like going to the White House. We were just like, oh, we're gonna thank Jay-Z and Beyonce
for being here.
It was like an honor to the NBA players, and like, those guys are so rich, nobody impresses them. But Jay-Z and Beyonce impressed them. Sure. I mean, they were even going over and talking to Blue Ivy of like, oh, how is everything, you know? And you're like, whoa. They're famous.
It's a dirty trick to get to the parents.
Yeah,
talk
yeah.
To
their,
the
their fame is
supersedes, yeah.
I would say. I like and it got me to think about famous couples in America. Who's more famous than them? Maybe Kim Kardashian and Kanye?
I mean.
But Kanye's not.
For different reasons, though.
Yes, yes.
Like, and you wouldn't want them to represent your political movement
or
in Cuba.
I wouldn't want to hang out with them.
Wouldn't hang out with them.
It just, that would be a weird time, wouldn't it?
It would be really uncomfortable. I don't think they're, I hope, in my mind, I'm maybe projecting, but I feel that Beyonce and Jay-Z are probably classy enough that they'll make you feel welcome. And
yes.
If you go to their house,
yes.
Right? If you hang out with them, they know how to host. They know how to have a party. I feel that Kim Kardashian they would be very, it'd be weird.
Yep.
You'd be walking on eggshells. Kanye would be like playing you these weird comedy albums. And this is funny, right?
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, Kanye.
And I will say this. A friend of mine produced a few of those Beyonce videos. And they got to go to New York and hang out with them and whatever. And they were like, dude, most down to earth, nicest people on the planet. Unbelievably
maybe
friendly.
Maybe not all the time, but when they have guests,
at home,
I think they know how to turn it on.
Yeah.
Which is great.
And they had the whole like a spread out, like
sure.
And they said it was phenomenal. They were like, man, they're fucking rad.
Yeah.
Kanye, I bet you Kanye on his meds is probably pretty cool. Where he's just like, hey, let's try some shit. I don't know what I would say to Kim Kardashian. Like, hey.
You actually would probably have a better conversation with Kim Kardashian.
You think so?
You guys could talk about business. You could talk about, I don't know. Like,
I don't know.
I don't know how you get, and she said this before, but I don't know how you get to her position without having just a tiny bit of smart.
I get it. No, no, no.
I
totally get that. I just don't know what we would have in common. Like if we were going to have dinner, like, because I always think about this. If you're going to sit down and have a dinner with somebody, like an hour and a half, a nice dinner with somebody out, what that conversation is, what it's like. I know what I would talk about with Kanye. Like with Kanye, I know what I would talk about. Like,
how,
you know, what the process is and making stuff. You know.
Yeah, but if you catch him on the right day, I guess.
Catch him on the right meds. With Kim Kardashian, I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. What am I going to talk to her about?
Yeah. Her branding?
I guess. But it's, you know, that's on a different planet.
Oh,
and is she really doing it?
Killed? Just be like, what up? How was that? Almost getting killed and shit.
When you were duct tape and bound in a bathtub.
What was that
What was that
Do you want to talk about it?
Because I remember being in an uncomfortable stitch in a bathtub
once.
Get
some jalapeno poppers and talk about your... I'm sure we'd order
jalapeno poppers. I like how you assume that we would take them to like Fridays.
Where else are we going to do that?
Yeah, yeah. We go, how about an awesome blossom, Kim?
Yeah. And let's really get into that.
Yeah.
Near death.
Yeah.
And like, are you still feeling it? What is it like?
Have you had the chili con carne?
Yeah.
Have you had the chili con carne? It is delightful here. Have you had the Wallaby Darns at Outback?
I will get the rum punch for two.
Yeah.
And just for me, though.
Just for me. No, I don't. I don't know what I would talk to them about.
I guess you're right.
It could happen. It might happen someday. So you never know.
Yes, we need to think about this.
I know.
We need to start planning now because we are really super duper famous.
Yeah, soup's famous. Look, the Ross Patterson Revolution is taking off. She'll probably be on the show next week.
Obviously.
Who knows? And then that being said, this is also the weekend.
Yes.
That the MLB, Major League Baseball, fantasy draft happens, which you love. You love.
I love anything. Fantasy.
The word fantasy as a grown man.
It's hard for me.
As an adult.
It's really hard for me.
It's hard to wrap your mind around.
It is. And a little word of advice to those ladies out there, the couple that are listening.
Yeah, the two in our demographic.
Be careful what you pretend to like when you're dating, okay? Because you will have to deal with it.
The rest of your life.
But if I were to get into any fantasy, I think it would be MLB. I think I'd be down for that. I'm a baseball gal.
You are a baseball fan. You're a big you're a Yankees fan.
Yeah. So, I think I can.
Yankees
get down
aren't good
it.
Though. I don't like. There's no, not.
They
I don't,
aren't.
I wouldn't
right
choose any Yankees on my fantasy MLB team.
And the I weird, can admit that.
The weird part about it is, I used to play with my friends. I beat them so bad that it was just like I needed other challenges. So I got invited to this other
You're like the worst.
I know.
Person.
Worst human on the planet.
Okay, carry
so
on.
I know. But at least I'm admitting it. I'm telling you. Like I was like, I'm above
so
my
I had
friends
to get
in this.
New
like
friends.
I've got to.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. Here's the sickness. So like I went on like this like crazy message board and found like these underground leagues with like the top champions who had won before.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, and they had to invite you into this like weird champions league. So that's what happened.
Okay.
So I got into this like underground like super hyper competitive like champions league, and I've done well. I think I've won 4 out of the last 7 years.
Okay. You're very good at that.
I'm good. I'm great. Yeah, I'm great at fantasy football. Great at fantasy baseball. I don't know anything
about.
I don't know anything
half.
About fantasy basketball. I don't play that. But it's something I think because as a writer, you're looking for something to kill the time,
yeah.
And it's something that it takes your mind off something. Where you're like, I could look up the scores once a day. Like no big deal.
Yeah.
I can do it on my phone or
it's
whatever it is.
Another thing to check.
Well, just one thing where you're like, all right, am I beating somebody at something in life today?
I like that.
Yeah. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Because in when you're writing or making movies or whatever it is, you're not beating anyone. You're just going up against yourself, and you're it's kind of boring, you know. At certain times, so you're like, I need something to spice this up.
Before DraftKings ended up being like some dumb thing that is all algorithm.
It's a scam, yeah.
I loved that for for fantasy baseball.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Because
it
was really instant. You could play just the day.
Yes.
They're not a sponsor or anything, but
no, they're not a sponsor.
Not a sponsor, but
by the way, they
combined. Liked
it. Yeah, you did. Yeah,
I did. But then when I found out there was no way that I could possibly
that you were
win,
playing a robot. Yeah.
Yeah. Then I was like, again.
And by the way, for anybody out there who doesn't know what we're talking about, FanDuel and DraftKings, they actually combined. Yeah. So they're one company now.
So that they have more money to pay for the lawsuits.
Exactly.
Okay.
Because there's a ton of lawsuits there. But I will say this in case you're at home and thinking, oh man, I can pick up some extra cash, maybe pay my mortgage that month by doing it. Don't. It turns out you're up against an algorithm that is it's impossible to beat. And then there's websites that will supply you with the algorithm for these.
Yeah.
Challenges. So it's like, you know, fantasy football and all this other stuff. Because you're like, we tried it.
Yeah.
Somebody sent over a few credits or whatever it was. And mm-hmm. they were like, hey, try this out. Talk about it on the show. So I tried it. And I was like, we almost won. And I felt, and I was like, oh, man, if I would have picked this other player, I totally would have won.
Sure.
Then we tried it the next week. And it was like, wait a minute. This, whoever this is picking people that I've never even heard of.
The house will always win.
It turns out we were up against algorithms and people were paying for this. And what they're doing is you're paying for 20 games at a time in a row. So you're betting on 20 different players, the algorithm and these robots and shit. And then there's no way you can beat them.
No.
There's no way. Unless you just happen to pick the greatest. Like we had a buddy who
even
won 20.
Then,
we had a friend who won 20 grand and picked it on his own and picked the thing, and then I was like,
he wasn't working with algorithm.
No, and what is a good story. So he won $20,000 on DraftKings, and was like, "I'm fucking awesome. I can beat anybody. I can beat the computer." Then so he slowly started kept playing.
Okay.
Slowly started losing the money. Dropped 10 grand, 12 grand, 15 grand. You know the story.
Yeah.
Gets down to the last five. Then he starts paying these algorithm sites. Total, he ended up with, I think he said he walked away with $2,800 like by the end of it.
Ugh.
But you can't beat the algorithms forever, kids.
No.
Can't
beat the house.
Can't do it. Can't do it. It's that time in the show, Jables.
For what?
The revolutionary figure of the week. Today's revolutionary figure of the week is a man named Frank E. Young. He was a man with a vision. And that vision involved things being inserted into other people's rectums.
What?
Yep. Developed in 1892, but not marketed until the turn of the century. His rectal dilator?
Yes, it's
dilator. Was a terrifying 4.5 inches of pain designed to go where the stars never shine. We're talking about the first ever butt plug, people. That's Frankie Young.
No.
That is Frankie Young. What does the E stand for? Everywhere? I don't know.
Everything?
Everything. He invented the first butt plug ever to be used in the world. And we salute him. We salute you, Frank.
On President's Day, I think appropriate. Appropriate. Yeah.
How many presidents do you think have used butt plugs in the White House? I think it's alarmingly high.
I think it's more than 60. Wait, how many presidents have we had?
We're on 45. Yeah, yeah. So nowhere near that. Nowhere near. Maybe we're only 60. On 40. Yeah, I think it's 60. I think it's 60.
Okay.
We're on 45 presidents only. Jables.
You really broke the glass ceiling.
Yeah, broke the glass ceiling. God.
I love the hashtag glass ceiling.
Glass ceiling. Everybody keeps hashtagging our Instagram, Ross Patterson Revolution, with that. But yeah, I'm going to go a hard 16 presidents. I'll go 16 of you butt plugs in the White House.
That's a low number.
I don't know. That's more than 30%.
Okay.
It's more than 30% of you butt plugs in the office.
in the office.
In the White House. In the Oval Office. I don't look. Because you know, once you get in, you're probably like, all right, let's
fuck this shit up.
Yeah, let's fuck all over this house. Like, let's fuck in the Oval Office. Let's fuck in the Lincoln bedroom. Let's do the goddamn thing.
Yeah.
I'm sure some butt plugs have been out. I'm going to go with 16.
All right.
16.
Well, I will look into that.
Yeah.
And I will have the answer on the next show.
Do some research. Okay. Do some research on all 60 presidents.
Yes.
And for those at home. We love you. Happy President's Day.
Happy President's Day.
This is a fun show. Also, you can get some sweet t-shirts on RossPattersonRevolution.com. That's RossPattersonRevolution.com. Grab yourself some t-shirts. They're a nice tri-blend. They're not a Gildan. They're not going to scratch you. They're not going to itch you. These are the kinds that you don't give to girls on one night stand because they're not they're that nice of a quality of shirt.
Sure.
For Jesse Wiseman. The Jables. I am Ross Patterson. This is the revolution. Good day. Good President's Day to you, sir.
Good day.
Good night. Bye.